Hello everyone, my name is Catherine and this is EleWebDev. EleWebDev is short for Elementor Website Development. This channel is dedicated to beginners and intermediates of the Elementor page builder for WordPress. Today's topic is about converting sections into containers. And you're asking yourself, what is a container? And why do I need to know? Well, you need to know because Elementor is going to be converting its code base into containers, which is technically called the Flexbox model. I know that's a lot, but I'm here to help you learn how to use containers and how to convert your already section-based builds into containers. And I know people don't like change, but we're going to do this and we're going to do it together. So what I'm going to do is let you know that this feature is coming. You can actually turn it on right now. I don't suggest you do that. That is just a big fat whoa Nelly. Do not turn this feature on because it, again, is experimental. Don't turn on containers just yet. But if you have an environment such as LocalWP, and that is LocalWP, the first green icon over there, LocalWP is a piece of software that allows you to build a local environment with WordPress. So we're going to get started today, and let me show you how to do this in a safe manner, learn how to use it, and learn along the way. So I use LocalWP on this computer, and all of my tutorials, I use this piece of software to serve up an environment that WordPress can work on my computer. This is not a server. I didn't buy a domain or web hosting. This piece of software, LocalWP, is what I'm using in order to make all this happen. So I highly suggest that if you want to learn the containers, I suggest downloading a piece of software like Local. There are other local hosting softwares out there. So pick one and use it. Here we are at the back end of Elementor. And I'm in the Elementor settings. And as you can see, Elementor has an experiments section. If we scroll down, there is an experimental feature called the Flexbox Container, and it is at a status alpha right now. And in code terms, that means it is very, very new and it can break things. So it is right now set to inactive. So we're just going to go to a page where I have already created. Now, this section is a section. You're looking at the final render. This is an actual section. Now, I will show you in just a minute. This color is light blue. The section handle is light blue. When you get into containers, they are going to be a darker teal color. And I'll alert you to that. So basically what I've got is four icon boxes set up, 1, 2, 3, 4, so you can tell the difference. I've got a title, a paragraph, and some counters here. And so what we want to do is, when you're ready to experiment, let's go change the settings for Elementor to turn this feature on. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back into Elementor Experimental Features. We're going to come back to this Flexbox Container. And I'm going to click on Inactive and I'm going to put it to Active. Now, when you set a change here in one of these dropdowns, you have to go to the bottom of the page and hit Save Changes. So I'm going to save those changes. And so now it has activated the Flexbox Container. So let's go back to my section here. Let me hit a hard refresh. Hard refresh for Macintosh users is Command Shift R. And for Windows, it's Control Shift R. We're going to now convert this into containers. So I'm going to come up here and I'm going to right click on my, there we are. There it is, edit section. And we're going to convert the container. And I'll expand this. It says copies of all the selected sections and columns and paste them in a container beneath the original. That's a bunch of word salad. What does that mean? It means I'm going to duplicate this, convert it into sections, and put it below. So let's just hit that convert button. And we can see right away that we've got problems. And this is where learning containers is going to be a sort of a learning curve. So let me just walk you through this. And the best way that I can explain it to you is containers have parents and they have children items. Parents and children, okay? Let's just parent-child. Parents can have children of widgets, or parents can have children that are other containers. And parents control children all the way around, okay? And you're going to see what I mean by the parent controls the children. Okay, so I'm going to scroll this up a little bit, and we're going to try to duplicate this layout with the containers. So first of all, we've got the parent container, and that is this container that has the tabs on it. If you want to consider this your section, we've got to change our vocabulary to this is the parent container. We have a child container, and that child container is this column right here, but it's a container. This is the child container of this parent, okay? And this container that is a child has children that are widgets. So in order to control the child widget, you have to control the, and in this case, the parent, which is the container, but there's another parent, there's the grandparent, if you will, in this case, this other container. You're going to just follow along with me. So the first thing we need to do is we need to make sure that these children widgets are going left to right, not top to bottom. So we need to make sure that, because the default setting is to go in a column. We want to make it a row. So I'm going to right click and edit the container, and I'm going to go to the items, and I want to say, please make a row. Well, that's all well and good, but they're all squeezed in and I need them to wrap. We need them to wrap. I only want two and then I want it to wrap. Okay. Well, that's great. We actually have a feature that forces the children to fit their width, whatever their designated width is, to wrap around. So I'm going to hit wrap. Well, wait a minute. I'm back to a column. Well, we've got this thing called elements gap, which is a default. We need to force this to be zero. If we take the gap out, the children will fit. Okay. So the children are now fitting, but unfortunately, we've got some stretching going on. So where does that stretching come from? Well, if I align the items to top, nothing really happens. So what if we go to the grandparent in this case and see what happens. So again, this is the parent of the widget items. We need to go to the grandparent, and I'm going to right click and edit that container. I'm going to go to items. Look at that. The grandparent has told them to stretch. We don't want it to stretch. We actually want them to go to the start, to the beginning. Hey. We got something working there. All right. So let's go do the same thing with these three widgets right here. We've got the parent container that holds them. But we've got these two items. These two items are great. And notice, know that the content is in a row. No, it's in a column. Excuse me. It's in a column. So if we go over here to this container and say, edit the container, and we say to the items, we want you to be in a row. Oh, well, then we've got a serious problem on our hands. We don't want everything to be in a row. We only want certain items to be in a row. Okay, fine. We'll turn that off. What I'm going to do is I'm going to say to some of these children, I want you to be 100% width and I don't want you to wrap. So I'm going to right click on this heading and I'm going to come over here and I'm going to go to advanced. And I want to say that the width of this child is going to be full width. Nothing happened. We're just telling child, hey, you fill 100% of the space. We're going to do the same thing to the text editor. We're going to come down here. We're going to say width in advanced, and we're going to say full width, 100%. So if I'm forcing these two children to be 100% of the width, and I say I want everything else to be in a row, well, let me right click on this container and let's go to the items and I want to say row. We still got a problem. Why don't we turn on that wrap feature? Ooh, we're getting close. We're getting close. Again, there's 25 or 20 in this case, elements gap. See how it's grayed out right here? The elements gap has a grayed out 20. That is a default. I wish they would make it zero. Please, Elementor, make it zero. But at any rate, we're going to force a zero in there. And voila. We have enabled all of this to look like the one up above. So if there's anything that I'm going to give you as a tidbit is, remember the parent-child relationship and the grandparent, because the grandparent can influence the contents of a child container. I know that's a whole lot of stuff to learn, but I hope that you've learned something in here. Yes, I'm going to continue to build things and show you how containers can make things, I'm not going to say easier, but it's a learning curve. But I'm going to be here with you to show that you can build just about anything with containers.